Dr. Popania. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss about the urea cycle. Urea is the end product of protein metabolism. The protein that is the made up of the amino acid. So it is also the amino acid metabolism end product. The nitrogen of the amino acid converted to ammonia is toxic to our body. The amino group of the amino acid, which is converted to the ammonia by the reactions, metabolism reactions like transamination and the deamination, converted into the ammonia. So ammonia is the toxic to the our body. So it is converted to the urea and it is detoxified. Urea account for the 80 to 90% of the nitrogen containing substances excreted in the urine. Generally, urea is synthesized in the liver. So, main organ where the urea is synthesized. Liver is the organ where the urea is synthesized and transported to the kidney for the excretion in the urine. Urea cycle, it is first metabolic cycle that was elucidated by the Hans Krebs and the Kurt Hanselrode cycle. So the cycle, urea cycle, it is also known as the Krebs-Hanselrode cycle. As we know, urea has two amino groups, one derived from the ammonia and the other from the aspartate moiety. Carbon atom is supplied by the carbon dioxide molecule. The structure of the urea that is contained one ketone group and the two amino group. One amino group that is derived from the ammonia, which is synthesized from the transamination and deamination reaction, and the other amino group that is comes from the aspartate moiety, and the carbon atom that is supplied by the carbon dioxide. Urea synthesis is a 5-step cyclic process with 5 distinct enzymes. The first 2 enzymes that is present in the mitochondria, while the rest are localized in the cytosol. The urea synthesis take place in the liver, which is 5-step cyclic process with the 5 different enzymes. So first 2 enzymes from the 5 different enzymes, they are present in the mitochondria, while the rest, that means 3 enzymes, present in the cytosol. So the urea synthesis, urea cycle, that is partially take place in the mitochondria and partially take place in the cytosol. The list of the reactions of the urea cycle. The first step, that is the synthesis of the carbamoyl phosphate. The second step, formation of the citrulline. Then the synthesis of the arginosuccinate. Then cleavage of the arginosuccinate. And last one, that is the formation of the urea. Main 5 reactions of the urea cycle in the urea synthesis. First, synthesis of the carbamoyl phosphate. Second, formation of the citrulline. Synthesis of the arginosuccinate and cleavage of arginosuccinate. And last, where the formation of the urea. The first step, synthesis of the carbamoyl phosphate. The carbamoyl phosphate synthesis of mitochondria catalyzes the condensation of ammonia ion with carbon dioxide to form carbamoyl phosphate. The first reaction, that is, take place in mitochondria with the help of CPS1 enzyme. The CPS1 enzyme means carbamoyl phosphate synthase enzyme, where there is a condensation of ammonium ion and carbon dioxide molecule which form the carbamoyl phosphate. This step consumes 2 ATP and it is the irreversible step. It is also a rate limiting step of the cycle. The CPS1, that means carbamoyl phosphate synthase 1, requires the N-acetyl glutamate for its activity. So for the activity of the CPS 1, there is a need of N-acetylglutamate. It accepts the amino group from the glutamine and does not require N-acetoglutamate for its activity. Another enzyme, that is the carbamoyl phosphate synthase 2, involves in the pyrimidine synthesis, which is present in the cytosol. The other CPS1, that is utilized in the urea synthesis, which is present in the mitochondria, where other enzyme, that is the carbamoyl phosphate synthase 2, which is involved in the pyrimidine synthesis, which is present in the cytosol. So the CPS2 enzyme that accepts the amino group from the glutamate and does not require the N-acetylglutamate for its activity. So CPS2, as compared to the CPS1, the CPS2 does not require the N-acetylglutamate for its activity, where the CPS requires the N-acetylglutamate for its activity. And CPS2 involves in the pyrimidine synthesis, whereas CPS1 involves in the urea cycle and it is present in the mitochondria, whereas CPS2 present in the cytosol. Here is the reaction, that where the carbon dioxide, ammonia, with the help of energy, 2 ATP required for the step. In the presence of carbamoyl phosphate synthase 1, the N-acetylglutamate for its activity, it's converted into the carbamoyl phosphate. The 2 ATP, that is converted into the 2 ADP, and the 1 inorganic phosphate is liberated in this reaction. So the carbon dioxide, ammonia condensation with the help of energy in the presence of carbamoyl phosphate synthase converted into the carbamoyl phosphate. Next, formation of the citrulline. Citrulline is synthesized from the carbamoyl phosphate and the ornithine by ornithine transcarbamylase. In this step of the formation of the citrulline, where the citrulline is synthesized from the carbamoyl phosphate and the ornithine, which is present already in the mitochondria by the ornithine transcarbamylase. The carbamylase, the enzyme which contains this ornithine and the carbamoyl phosphate. The carbamoyl phosphate is obtained from the carbon dioxide and the ammonia, and the ornithine is condensed with the carbamoyl phosphate. Ornithine is regenerated and used in the urea cycle. The ornithine, its role is comparable to the oxaloacetate in the citric acid. In the oxaloacetate, in the citric acid, where the oxaloacetate is regenerated in the citric acid cycle, same way the ornithine is condensed with the carbamoyl phosphate and further reactions, it will regenerate again in the end of the urea cycle. Ornithine and the citrulline, they are the basic amino acids. The citrulline produced in the reaction is transported to the cytosol by a transporter system. So first and the second reaction, where the enzymes for that reaction is present in the mitochondria. The first, that is the CPS1, and the second, that is the ornithine transcarbamylase. Next, after the formation of the citrulline is transported into the cytosol by the transporter system for the further action. The ornithine, which is present in the mitochondria, and the carbamoyl phosphate, which condenses through the carbon dioxide and the ammonium moiety. Here the ornithine and the carbamoyl phosphate both are reacted and the form the citrulline molecule. In the presence of ornithine, transcarbamide release. Further citrulline is transported into the cytosol. From the third reaction, it will take place in the cytosol. The third reaction, that is the synthesis of the arginosuccinate. The arginosuccinate synthase condenses the citrulline with aspartate to produce the arginosuccinate. The third reaction, that is the name of synthesis of arginosuccinate, that means formation of the arginosuccinate. The arginosuccinate form from the citrulline, which is comes from the mitochondria. So citrulline and aspartate moiety, aspartate that is the amino acid. So citrulline and aspartate that condense, which make the arginosuccinate. The responsible for this reaction, the enzyme is arginosuccinate synthase enzyme. The second amino group of the urea is incorporated in this reaction. The first amino group of the urea is the ammonium ion, which is incorporated from the first reaction, where the second amino group of the urea is incorporated in this reaction in the form of the aspartate. In the aspartate, there is an amino group which is present, which is incorporated in the urea. So citrulline plus aspartate gives the arginosuccinate moiety. This step requires the ATP, which is cleaved to AMP and the pyrophosphate. So the latter is immediately broken to inorganic phosphate. Again, in the first step, 2 ATP that is the required for the reaction, and the third reaction also require the energy. The next step, that is the cleavage of arginosuccinate. So the third reaction, where the synthesis of the arginosuccinate, so this moiety arginosuccinate is cleaved in the fourth reaction. The arginosuccinase, for this reaction, the enzyme is arginosuccinase, cleaves the arginosuccinate to give arginine and the fumarate. In the third reaction, there is a arginosuccinate synthase enzyme is responsible. In the fourth reaction, there is a arginosuccinase which cleaves the arginosuccinate to give the arginine and the fumarate moiety. Arginine is the immediate precursor for the urea, and fumarate liberated here provide a connecting link with the TCA cycle as well as the gluconeogenesis cycle. The arginine from where the urea is formed and the fumarate is liberated, where it provides to the connecting link with the TCA cycle as well as the gluconeogenesis cycle. Here the fumarate, which is formed during the cleavage of arginosuccinate, it converted into the malate in the presence of fumarase, and further malate converted into the oxaloacetate in the presence of malate dehydrogenase, which is going to the or the linking to the TCA cycle. Or the oxaloacetate further converted with the aminotransferase enzyme converted into the aspartate. It is also goes through the gluconeogenesis cycle as well as the further reactions. So the arginine, there is a precursor of the urea, and the fumarate, there is a connect the link with the TCA cycle as well as the gluconeogenesis cycle. The fifth step of the formation of urea, the arginase enzyme is the fifth and the final enzyme that cleaves the arginine to yield urea and the ornithine. In the fifth reaction, the urea is synthesized as well as the ornithine, which is regenerated in the cycle. The fifth enzyme, that is the arginase enzyme. The ornithine is regenerated and enters into the mitochondria for its reuse in the cycle. So ornithine that is transported further in the mitochondria and again condensed with the carbamoyl phosphate and the cycle is continues. Arginase enzyme is activated by the cobalt and the manganese. The arginase is mostly found in the liver, where the rest of the enzyme of the urea cycle are also present in the other tissue. So the arginase that is the enzyme which responsible for the urea synthesis that is only present in the liver, while the other enzyme which we saw in the all four reactions, they are present in the other tissues. For this reason, arginine synthesis may occur to varying degrees in many tissue, but only the liver can ultimately produce the urea. So arginase is the only present in the liver. So the liver is the only organ where the urea is produced. Here is the urea cycle pathway. In the first reaction, the formation or synthesis of the carbamoyl phosphate. Here, the carbon dioxide molecule and the ammonium molecule condense with each other in the presence of carbamoyl phosphate synthase 1, CPS1, and produce the carbamoyl phosphate. CPS1, that is the enzyme, requires the activity for its activity, that is the N-acetyl glutamate. The reaction is the rate limiting step. The reaction also requires the energy, so it utilizes the 2 ATP. So 2 ATP is converted into the 2 ADP and 1 inorganic phosphate. The next reaction, second reaction, formation of the citrulline. Here the carbamoyl phosphate and the ornithine, which is present in the mitochondria, in the presence of ornithine transcarbamylase enzyme, converted into the citrulline. The one and the two step, first and the second step, which is take place in the mitochondria. The rest of the reactions which are take place in the cytosol. So the next, citrulline. The citrulline with the L-aspartate, the aspartate which incorporated into the citrulline converted into the arginosuccinate moiety. This reaction is in the presence of arginosuccinate synthase, and the ATP is required for this reaction. Citrulline and the aspartate moiety converted into the arginosuccinate. So this step, that is the formation of the arginosuccinate. The next, fourth step, that is the cleavage of the arginosuccinate. In this, there is a removal of the fumarate and the formation of the arginine. The responsible for this reaction, that is the arginosuccinase enzyme. The fumarate further, they goes into the TCA cycle as well as the gluconeogenesis cycle, and the arginine, it is the precursor for the urea synthesis. So arginine, with the help of the arginase enzyme, it is converted into the urea molecule, and the with the liberation of the urea molecule, there is a conversion of the ornithine, which ornithine is again transported into the mitochondria for the continue the cycle. So ornithine is regenerated in this cycle. So first, that is the carbamoyl phosphate synthase 1 enzyme. Second step, that is the ornithine transcarbamylase enzyme. In the third step, there is the arginosuccinate synthase enzyme, arginosuccinase enzyme, fourth reaction, and the arginase enzyme. So the four fifth enzymes, they are the different one for the reaction. First two enzyme which is present in the mitochondria, and the rest of enzyme there is the in the cytosol. Energetics of the urea cycle. The urea cycle is irreversible and consumes the 4 ATP. 2 ATP are utilized for the synthesis of carbamoyl phosphate. 1 ATP that is converted to the AMP and the pyrophosphate to produce the arginosuccinate, which equals to the 2 ATP. Hence the 4 ATP, they are the actually consumed. So here the ammonium and the carbon dioxide, the aspartate moiety, and the here 3 ATP, they converted into the urea, fumarate, 2 ADP. So ammonia, then carbon dioxide, aspartate in the 3 ATP, which is utilized for in the urea cycle. The here with the product, that is the urea, then the fumarate, 2 ADP. After the ATP is utilized, the ADP is removed, and the 2 phosphate, the inorganic phosphate, 2 AMP, that is the AMP, utilization of the ATP, and the 1 pyrophosphate, that is liberated in the reactions. Significance of the urea cycle. Toxic ammonia is converted into the non-toxic urea. The ammonia which is toxic to the our body, which is the product after the transamination and the deamination of amino acid reactions, which is converted into the non-toxic urea. Synthesis of the semi-essential amino acid, that is the arginine. Arginine, that is the semi-essential amino acid. So in this reaction, arginine is produced. So synthesis of the semi-essential amino acid. Ornithine is precursor for the proline and the polyamines. The ornithine which is utilized for the proline and the polyamine synthesis. The polyamines. Polyamines, that is the utilized in the cell growth and the proliferation. So polyamines include the putrescine, spermidine, and the spermine. So here the importance of the urea cycle. First, toxic ammonia is converted to non-toxic urea. Then synthesis of the semi-essential amino acid, that is the arginine. Next, ornithine, that is the precursor of the proline and the polyamines. The polyamines, that is the example, that is putrescine, spermidine, and the spermine. And the polyamines, which is unique role in the diversity role in cell growth as well as the cell proliferation. Next, regulation of the urea cycle. The first reaction catalyzed by the CPS1, that is the rate limiting step. So that is CPS1, they regulate the whole urea cycle. So CPS1 is allosterically activated by the NAG, that is the N-acetyl glutamate. It is synthesized from the glutamate and the acetyl coenzyme A by the synthase enzyme and degraded by the hydrolase enzyme. The CPS1, the first reaction for the formation of the carbamoyl phosphate, it is a rate limiting step, and the it regulates the whole urea cycle. The CPS1, for its activity, it needs the N-acetyl glutamate. The N-acetyl glutamate, which is synthesized from the glutamate and the acetyl coenzyme A by the synthase enzyme and degraded by the hydrolase enzyme. Here the energy synthase enzyme, the acetyl coenzyme A and the glutamate, it forms the N-acetyl glutamate. And the hydrolysis of the N-acetylglutamate that in the presence of the hydrolase enzyme. The rate of the urea synthesis in the liver correlated with the concentration of the N-acetylglutamate. The high concentration of the arginine increases the NAG. For the synthesis, urea synthesis rate, there is a correlated with the concentration of the NAG. In this, the arginine, that is high concentration of the arginine, which increase the NAG. The consumption of the protein rich meal increase the level of NAG in the liver, leading to the enhanced urea synthesis. The protein rich meal, when consumption of that, so increase the level of NAG because of the high concentration of the protein in our body. So it ultimately increase the energy. So increase the level of energy, it enhance the urea cycle, urea synthesis in our body. Carbamol phosphate synthesis CPS1 and the glutamate dehydrogenase are localized in the mitochondria. They coordinate with each other in the formation of the ammonia and its utilization for the synthesis of the carbamol phosphate. The both enzyme, that is the CPS1 and the glutamate dehydrogenase, which is responsible for the removal of ammonia from the glutamate, both are the localized in the mitochondria. So they coordinate to each other for the reaction and the formation of the ammonia. So the ammonia, that is the utilization for the synthesis of carbamol phosphate in the urea cycle. The remaining four enzymes of the urea cycle, they are mostly controlled by the concentration of respective their substrates. Next, metabolic disorder of the urea cycle. The main function of the urea cycle is to remove the toxic ammonia from the blood is urea. The urea cycle, the main importance of that is the removal of the toxic ammonia from our body. Defect in the metabolism of conversion of the ammonia to urea, that is the urea cycle, leads to the hyperammonemia or the ammonia intoxication. The defect in the metabolism of this ammonia, there is a conversion of the ammonia to urea. In the process, there is a defect, it leads to the hyperammonemia and the ammonia intoxication. Hyperammonemia, inherited disorder of the urea cycle, the enzyme familial, the hyperammonemia. Acquired disorder, that is the liver disease, that is severe renal disease, acquired hyperammonemia. Next, ammonia toxicity, that is the increase the level of the ammonia which cross the blood brain barrier and the formation of the glutamate. Then more utilization of the alpha ketoglutarate in the body, so they decrease the level of the alpha ketoglutarate in brain. So alpha ketoglutarate, that is the key intermediate in the tricarboxylic Krebs cycle, that decrease the level of which impairs the TCA cycle and the decrease the ATP production in the our body. So ammonia toxicity, where the increased level of ammonia which cross the BBB, so formation of the glutamate, the increase the level of the glutamate, so more utilization of the alpha ketoglutarate. The more utilized alpha ketoglutarate, so there is a decrease the level of alpha ketoglutarate in the brain. In the TCA cycle, alpha ketoglutarate is the main key ingredient in the cycle. So the defect in the TCA cycle is produced. So there is a decreased ATP production in the TCA cycle. Here, when the ammonia is cross the blood brain barrier, where the alpha ketoglutarate is present, so they are combined and produce the glutamate in the presence of glutamate dehydrogenase enzyme. So the utilization is alpha ketoglutarate utilized more when the ammonia is transported into the BBB and form the glutamate. Inherited disorders in the neurocycle. Here the some listed disorders which the defective enzymes is responsible. First, hyperammonemia 1. The defective enzyme for that is the carbamoyl phosphate synthase 1, CPS1. So the product that is the ammonia is accumulated in the body. Second, that is the hyperammonemia 2, the enzyme that is the ornithine transcarbamylase, and as well as ammonia is the accumulated. Citrullinemia, for that the arginosuccinate synthase enzyme where the citrulline is accumulated. Arginosuccinic aciduria, that is the arginosuccinate lyase, that is the arginosuccinate, the product is accumulated in the body. Argininemia, that is the arginase enzyme is defected, the arginemia is produced. Here the arginine is the accumulated in the body. Blood urea significance, the normal blood urea concentration, that is the 10 to 40 milligram per deciliter. The 15 to 30 gram of the urea is excreted in the urine per day. So the blood urea estimation is screening test for the evaluation of the kidney function. The main, that is the concentration, normal range, that is the 10 to 40 milligram per deciliter. In that, there is a 15 to 30 gram urea is present in the urine. The blood urea estimation test for screening test for the kidney function, where the kidney is properly functioned or not. Elevation in the blood urea may broadly classified into the categories. The pre-renal, that is these associated with the increased protein breakdown leading to the negative nitrogen balance. Observed after the major surgery, prolonged fever, diabetic coma, thyrotoxicosis. In leukemia and the bleeding disorder, the blood urea is the elevated. Pre-renal, that is associated with the increased protein breakdown, where the protein breakdown is increased, in which pre-renal is associated, which leads to the negative nitrogen balance, where in the diet protein is less and the breakdown of the protein in our body is high, so it goes into the negative nitrogen balance. When observed in the major surgery, prolonged fever, diabetic coma and thyrotoxicosis, as well in the leukemia and the bleeding disorder, the blood urea is elevated. Next, renal. In the renal disorder, there is a glomerular nephritis, chronic nephritis, nephrosclerosis, polycystic kidney, the blood urea is increased. In this category, most of the glomerular nephritis, chronic nephritis, nephrosclerosis and polycystic kidney, all disorder that is of renal, related to the renal. So this category is mostly renal disorder is described, where the blood urea is increased. Next category, post-renal. Due to the obstruction in the urinary tract, like tumor, stone, enlargement of the prostate gland, the blood urea is elevated. This is due to the increased reabsorption of urea from the renal tubules. In the post-renal, in that there is a obstruction in the urinary tract by the tumors, stone or the enlargement of the prostate gland, where the blood urea is elevated. In this situation, there is a increased the reabsorption step of urea from the renal tubules. So there are the three categories of the blood urea significance: pre-renal, renal and the post-renal. Thank you. थैंक यू।